interview or story on Wilma Rudolph Mon Olympia that indeed has been appreciated in America till date. Joining us on the show this afternoon, I have Beth Chukwu, a psychotourist who indeed is thinking of great things with his bicycle. Ben, good afternoon to you.
It's good to be here.
And Ben, let's take a look at your journey. In the next couple of hours, you will indeed be traveling with your bicycle to Ghana. How are you looking forward to the journey?
Yeah, it's going to be fun and challenging as well. So I hope to complete that in 7 days.
In 7 days?
Yeah.
What do you mean 7 days? Is it just going to Ghana alone or going and coming?
That's the entire journey.
The entire journey?
Yeah.
7 days. So how many days will it take you to get to Ghana?
I'm looking at 3 days to get to Ghana. And 3 days, 1 day rest, then 3 days coming back.
Okay. You rest for a day and then you come back within 3 days. We can indeed see you on screen right now. Where did you take that picture?
That's somewhere at a head bridge in Onitsha.
Okay. How many days did it take you to get to Onitsha? Was Onitsha your destination?
I was actually coming riding from Imo State, to Lagos. So it was a 3 days journey.
How come you enjoy, cycling from one state to another, and then you're thinking of something huge in the future, moving from Africa to Europe or what?
Yeah, certainly I hope to do that if I could get sponsors for that.
What's the motivation behind this?
The motivation I wish to see the whole world, but doing it with my bicycle.
With your bicycle. Well, I'm sure that will have more questions for you, Dabo.
Well, you'll be touring from Lagos to Ghana. What is the drive behind this? What message are you trying to put across?
Okay, basically, I wish to use this tour to raise awareness against child labor, child trafficking, and child abuse. So that's the message I'm carrying along with me.
Okay, what's that with you? On the screen, we can see the picture of you with another cyclist. Who's that?
Okay, that's a friend. He's an Indian. His name is Soumen Devner. He has actually gone about 120 countries on bicycle and is still going. So he hopes to
120 countries?
Yeah. He hopes to complete his world tour in the year 2020.
In the year 2020?
Yeah.
Well,
Then what gave you, how did you start this? Did you just wake up one day and say, okay, I want to, do cycling tour to send social message? And what gave you the motivation? How did you actually start?
Did you get paid for this? No, that.
I'm not getting paid for rich. So how I got into this was I used to play active football. So when I had a knee problem, I had to use it to recuperate and get back into. So I find myself riding from state to state as a way of improving money, which actually helped. So from there, I decided to do something.
To drop football?
To stop playing active football and get into cycling.
So when do you intend leaving for Ghana tomorrow?
Hopefully this weekend I will be leaving for Ghana.
Okay, this weekend you'll be leaving for Ghana, and which route will you be taking to Ghana?
I will be taking from Lagos to Benin Republic, to Togo, and to Ghana, then back.
Okay, Dabo.
Yeah, this is a venture. Let's call it a project. It's capital intensive. How are you getting the sponsorship to do this? Because you need somewhere to sleep, you need food, you need supplements, you need all these things. How are you doing it?
Right. Basically now it's self-sponsored, but I am looking forward to getting sponsors. I know it's capital intensive, and I look forward to getting the sponsors by the time I will be doing bigger projects, that's particularly my race across Africa on bicycle from Cairo, Egypt to Cape Town, South Africa.
Well, I'm sure you draw inspiration from your friend who is an Indian and who is hoping to complete his world tour by the year 2020. What are some of the experiences he has shared with you, you know, with cycling, and then some of the challenges he had?
Yeah, some of the challenges could be security.
Okay.
So, we have we've been hearing more terrorist attacks and kidnapping for across the world now. So these are some of the challenges. I think in one of his stories, he made mention of when he was kidnapped by Taliban somewhere in Afghanistan, and that was, it took the intervention of the Indian president for him to be released. That's quite challenging.
Oh, interesting. And the Indian president at any point in time flagged off his cycling tour?
Yeah, the Indian president then, because his cycling tour around the world started in 2004, then the president of India was a minister. He flagged that for him. So he is still cycling. It's probably going to be ending the cycling 2020.
And if you're looking at yours across the continent of Africa, how many years will it take you?
No, it's not going to be. I look forward to doing that thing in less than 40 days across Africa on bicycle.
In less than 40 days?
Yes. There's a Scottish adventurer, Beaumont, actually did that last year in 42 days. So I look forward to doing that in less number of days.
Well, I must say a very big thank you, Ben Chukwu, who indeed is a tourist when it comes to cycling. And then we will be departing for Ghana this weekend. I'm trying to do that in 3 days. We wish you the best of luck and indeed and have fun while cycling.
Thank you so much.
That was Shotimi Namosi, a very big thank you. Not forgetting College Udeme. Tomorrow indeed will be another time. You can join us 12:30 to 1:30 Nigerian time for another exciting ride in the world of sport. Till I come your way again, me and Akili on behalf of the crew, good afternoon.